On our video blog, we've been doing a series about coil binding, and although I did do a vlog explaining how the margins of your pages have to be a little bit different for coil binding, I thought this helpful diagram that Liz made would make things even clearer. So let's imagine that this is the first page of your coil bound book. Since it's page number one, it's an odd numbered page. The pink half inch margins are your regular page margins that you would already have set up. See the artwork and the text and the page numbers all inside your pink half inch margins. The purple is the extra half inch that you want to add to your regular margin on the left side to make room for where the coil is going to come in, because the coil is going to come in right here. Together, these two half inches make an inch, so on the left side of your odd numbered pages, you want to have an inch margin, including your half inch regular margin, to make room for the coil. So let's say that you flip the page. Now it becomes an even numbered page because it's page two. Imagine when you flip the page over in a book, everything becomes a bit reversed because it's turned over. So you've still got your regular half inch margins in the pink, got your artwork and everything inside those margins, and notice now that it's on the right side that you have to account for the coil because the page is flipped over. So this inch, which is your regular half inch margin in the pink, and the purple, which is the extra half inch for the coil, will be on the right side now. Sometimes having a more practical demonstration can be really helpful for understanding concepts. So here are the same two pages printed out. This is the first page of your coil bound book. Here are your regular, the pink, the 5-inch margins, and here's the extra half inch in the purple that you want to add where the coil goes. So notice that the coil goes on the left here, but if we were to open this book up, for pretend, this would be the next page, the even page, which would be the back of the odd page. So notice that now it's going to be right here, this extra half inch in the purple where your coil goes. So I just also wanted to say that while margins might seem different on different sizes of paper, it's always a half inch that you want to add to make room for the coil. That's always as much room the coil needs. Even if you feel like your coil might be bigger or smaller than average. So for example, here's a really, really like tiny coil. But notice that, see, this is still a half inch that it needs. It's just because the coil actually extends out. Coil is measured in millimeters, and even though this is a smaller millimeter coil, it goes out even if it gets bigger. So here's a really big coil. Still, the margin is a half inch because the punching still takes up the same amount of room, and the coil, when it's bigger, the diameter extends outwards, so you don't have to worry. If you have any questions, you can leave us a comment on our YouTube page right below this video. You can always email us or leave a question on our Facebook page, and we'll definitely get back to you.